up, Sailor Senshi? I'm Sailor Snubs. Welcome to my YouTube channel all about Sailor Moon news and merch reviews. And today, let me get my thing. Today, I have a review for ya. Ta-da! This is Sailor Moon Super's part 2 of the show, the Blu-ray and DVD combo pack. Now, if you saw my last review of a Blu-ray and DVD combo pack on this channel, then you know that I got a spare one from Viz Media for review. So I did purchase my own copy because I'm all about that. I love my DVDs and Blu-rays, but I also got an extra one, which is still in the wrapper. And this one I'm going to be giving away at the end of this video. So definitely subscribe if you want to find out how you can win this copy, and make sure to subscribe so that you don't miss the giveaway winner announcement too, which will happen about 2 weeks after the airing of this video. So this is Sailor Moon Super's Part 2. This is a DVD and combo Blu-ray pack. It comes with 6 different discs in the entire box. Those consist of 3 Blu-rays and 3 DVDs. This has 20 episodes on it from 147 all the way up to 166. It is in full HD, which means 1080p, and it is in 4:3 aspect ratio as opposed to the movie, which was in 16:9, I believe it's called. They do include English stereo and Japanese audio too, and there are English subtitles, and there's a variety of subtitles too. So if you don't want subtitles for the songs, you can turn those off, for example. Viz Media has continued this gorgeous box set art, just like they have on the previous seasons, both parts 1 and 2 from the original season R and S and Supers part 1 too. You do see some really, really pretty holographic decals on the edges printed on. They're very pretty. It says Sailor Moon Supers on the front. Does not tell you that it is a season, it just says Sailor Moon Supers, and then it has all of the inner Senshi, as well as Super Chibi Moon and Pegasus in the background. Very pretty. Sailor Moon is holding her Kaleida Moonscope, and Chibi Moon is holding her little twinkle heart thing. Whatever that thing is called. Both sides say the same thing. They say Sailor Moon Supers Season 4 Part 2 with all the Blu-ray, DVD, toy, and Viz Animation logos at the bottom and the Crescent's brooch at the top. And on the back, we get the synopsis or the plot of the show. We also get this really nice art of Helios and a few different animation stills from the actual episodes. So it does tell you that you get an art gallery, cast interviews, and opening and ending songs too, as just clean openings and endings in case you want to listen to those. And there's a few other things involved as well as far as extras go. So the plot for this season goes, spoiler alert, the hunt for Pegasus heats up after the evil Zirconia enlist the help of the mischievous but deadly Amazoness Quartet to find the mystical creature and the golden crystal he possesses for their ruler, the beautiful Queen Nehelenia. From hypnotic stage shows to energy-draining spiderwebs, the Amazoness Quartet seems to endanger even its own members in its attempt to obtain the golden crystal. What would they do if they discovered that Pegasus has chosen Chibiusa as his host? And why is Queen Nehelenia, they spelled it weird on the back of this box, so obsessed with obtaining the golden crystal? The Sailor Guardians are in for a real surprise as they uncover the Queen of Darkness's secret and her connection to Sailor Moon's past. Dun dun dun! All right, let's go ahead and open up the box set. So the box itself, the plastic, it does include the same exact information on front and back. Nothing new. Now there is something really cool in this sleeve though. So let me take this out nice and gently so I can show you. There's some extra art. Isn't that beautiful? It's so pretty. So this is some really pretty art. I believe this is by Marco Abiro. It looks like it is, at least. So you can just slip this right back into your sleeve whenever you're done looking at it, but that's what you're gonna see behind your Blu-rays and DVDs. So again, you do get 6 discs in the set. So the first 2 are Blu-rays, and those feature Mercury and Mars printed on the first one, and then we have Jupiter and Venus printed on the second one, and then we have an outline of the art of the Amazoness Quartet on the third Blu-ray. The DVDs are printed the exact same fashion, except the extras disc, the very last one of the DVD, is a lighter pink color or a lighter red, as opposed to the third one in the Blu-ray collection, and that one is a darker red. So let's go ahead and move on to showing you the graphics, the menu, and all those good things. So I'm just gonna go through the Blu-ray so you don't have to sit around for forever today because they both pretty much have the same information on them. So let's go ahead and start with disc one. And I'll run through the three Blu-rays with you. So let's start with the menu. The menu is really pretty. It has really nice background music as well, which I do appreciate whenever I'm looking at it or it's playing in the background. As far as extras go, there's a gallery. The gallery is really cool. It has pictures of Mars and Mercury in it, and it shows them from forward, from sideways, and backwards so that you get this really nice rendition and idea of what their outfits look like or their fukus throughout the entire show. I think this would be really great for cosplayers as well. So if you are a cosplayer and you're looking to, you know, do some Sailor Mars or Mercury cosplay, definitely check that out. You also have your subtitle options as usual, so I won't go through those. The episodes included on this disc are 147 through 153. And again, those are 4:3 aspect ratio. I did notice though that they are really, really clean. They're very vibrant. And smoothness. There's a lot of smoothness with the lines and with the drawings in the show. So it looks very good, especially in HD. You'll notice that the theme of this first disc is pretty much based on the colors of Mercury and Mars. And you will see kind of a pattern there going forward with the other discs too. So then we are on to disc number two. This one, the menu theme is more Jupiter and Venus colors, as you can see. The gallery here features Jupiter and Venus as well. A very, very pretty art and prints again of both of those characters. This Blu-ray features episodes 154 through 160, and that's pretty much all there is to say about this second Blu-ray disc. So then we move on to disc number three in the Blu-ray copies. So this one features a ton of extras. There are a bunch of interviews on here with all of the different English cast members, which I think is really cool. It's very interesting and kind of fascinating to listen to the voice actors, you know, ideas and opinions about the show. And all of them seem very excited, like they're, you know, they're one of us, they're nerds too. So I really appreciate listening to them and getting to hear some of their opinions. So we get an interview with Chibi Moon and Pegasus, which is Sandy Fox and Christopher Niosi. And honestly, Chris is so funny. Like, he is really good to listen to. Like, the dude, I feel like he would fit in at anime conventions, which is great because, you know, he's one of us. Sandy Fox has the highest pitch voice that I have ever heard, but it fits the character perfectly. There's also a Guardians interview, and this one is with Stephanie Shea, who does Sailor Moon, Kate Higgins, who does Sailor Mercury, Amanda Miller with Jupiter. Then there's Sharamie Lee, who does Sailor Venus. And then there's another interview with Chibi Moon again, or Sandy Fox, and the Outer Scouts. So this one features Erica Mendez, who does Uranus, Lauren Landa, who does Neptune, Veronica Taylor, who does Pluto, Christine Marie Cabanos, I think that's how you say her name, she does Saturn, and then there's Chris Niosi again with Pegasus. Lastly, we do have a couple of extra interviews. There's one with Eric Scott Kimmerer, who does Fisheye, and whoa, his voice for Fisheye is completely different than his actual voice, and then Chris Niosi on his own, which is also a really good one. There are also some galleries on the third disc, so I did want to mention those two. Those include pictures of Serenity, of course, Princess Serenity, and Small Lady, the Stallion Reeve, the Mirror, the four girls from the Amazonas Quartet, and Queen Nihilenia. And then this one also features episodes 161 through 166. So you can currently purchase this Part 2 Blu-ray and DVD combo pack. It is $47.99 over on Amazon Prime. It's definitely not a bad price at all, and they have gone down in price since they were first released, which was around $60 at the time. So if you want to win my extra DVD Blu-ray combo pack of Sailor Moon Supers Part 2 of the show, definitely comment below. And for this giveaway, I would like y'all to tell me, ooh, I know, I want to know what you are most excited about with Sailor Moon Stars. So this is very, very exciting. I'm super stoked because Sailor Moon Stars has never been released in the United States, legitimately. So this is the first time we're going to get an English dub of the show. Very, very cool. That's what I'm most excited about, but I want to hear what you're excited about. So in order to enter in this giveaway, tell me down below what you're most excited about with Sailor Moon Stars, and I will choose my favorite comment and give this special Blu-ray DVD combo to you. So I will announce the winner in about 2 weeks. So don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already so that you hear the announcement and you get a notification on your YouTube app. And thank you again so much for liking and commenting on all of my videos. I really appreciate it. Until next time, I am Sailor Snubs, and I have a bunch more videos in store for you, so stick around. Johnny!